Absa Premiership sides playing catch-up aim to maintain their unbeaten runs of the 2018-19 campaign as champions Mamelodi Sundowns hunt down consecutive wins for the first time this season, facing new boys back on the PSL block in Highlands Park who search for a first win whilst unbeaten since their return. We are live from Loftus Versfeld in a game that promises much in the battle for 3 points early on in the new campaign. Keep in mind this is just their third ever PSL era meets this between Sundowns and Highlands Park. Sundowns getting onto that bright star, Brocky going to ground and immediately looking on to Pelerin Indaba. Not convinced, no flag out on that far side from Mervin van Veek.
And in fact, it's the defender that first had to go down. There was definitely contact, but whether it was enough to get Brocky down, I'm not too sure. But a great opportunity indeed. But that first touch, not convincing from Brocky.
Sundowns. We have it here. Mocirinho fills it into Brocky. Oh, the defensive touch. I believe there was one. And what a touch. Flying through the air. Then is that Silva Matepe, who's done a stunning job with the defensive player of the day.
It looked like he was going over his head. That's why Brocky anticipated that he might drop just behind him. Oh, daring.
Wow. Brocky, I think, for a foul.
Which there was.
Raw frustration. Mr. Ndaba. We'll have all eyes on him here as Nascimento picks up the yellow card. There were moments of frustration in the first half. They've continued here in the second. Remember, Brocky thought he had a penalty very early. Inside 30 seconds or a minute in this match. Now, reaching into the back pocket, yeah, right! Talked himself into trouble, possibly Nascimento. And in the end, Tolalan Indaba. Oh, he's created Indaba.
From a nothing situation, but it was a case of frustration just growing from the Mamelodi Sundowns players. Now, what happens here?
Is there yellow there? This is the first question. Can Highlands Park grab the lead here? Under 30 to go. Firmino over it from the training grounds. It's Reds by Ray.
Wrong choice.
Firmino with a turn. Numbers in there. It's a good ball. Oh, what a save! What a save! What a save! And it's not even a goalkeeper. Defensive player of the season, possibly this time. Let's have a look. They're shouting VAR out in the stands. Oh, what a header. Oh, what a defensive play.
No, we need that. We need somebody to freeze that right on the edge of the line when the contact with the header is made.
Is this Spandi? Yes, it is. Now.
No.
The entire circumference of the ball needs to cross the line. No. He didn't cross the line.
Oh, that is brilliant.
Silva. Byline. Side net.
I think the timing is right to bring him in. And at a time where they were back foot for the most part, Mamelodi Sundowns. Fresh legs is obviously what will help tilt the scale. Maybe, even if it's for a few moments.
He's given the signal. Going for goal! Gabini! He needed to deal with a couple of bounces there.
He's been forced finally to make a save. Nearly scoring with his first kick.
At the end of a captivating 90 minutes of actual Premiership football, it's Mamelodi Sundowns 0, Highlands Park 0 in the clash of the champs. It's
much. Since Sibande was given the Absa Premiership Man of the Match, let's talk then about his performance tonight, the defensive performance, and in particular that clearance.
Yeah, I think, you know, he played 28 matches of the matches, of all the matches. He was the player who played the most matches in the NFD. And we broke the record for the least goals conceded in the NFD. So to come up against a formidable team like Sundowns, you know, the current champions of the PSL, and to come and play the way the boys play today, I'm just proud of these. There are, I mean, 7 or 8 debutants in the PSL, so I'm just happy that stars are being born.
Coach, in our pre-match interview, you said you wanted the boys not to ball watch. You said you want them to be defensively organized, but you don't want to park the bus. Mission accomplished?
Mission accomplished. The structure was well. Villa couldn't do anything. Zwane, who's their most influential player, if you study them, Villa is the most influential player. We closed him down. Zwane couldn't play. Villa couldn't play. Serino found it very tough. They created very few chances, but what I'm proud of is the structure of the team, the way the boys organize themselves, and from a tactical perspective, I thought we got it spot on.
A lot of ill discipline out there tonight. There were 8 yellow cards, there was 1 red card. How did that affect the game?
Yeah, I think when you don't get intimidated, when you show you're not going to get intimidated, you tend to intimidate the opposition. So these young boys went out and they showed that nobody's going to step all over them and walk all over them. They are going to fight. This is the Premiership League, and we came here to add value. We didn't come here just to add numbers.
Coach, are happy with the point tonight?
No, I would have been very happy with 3 points, but it's okay. We're happy. We played Pirates away. They ended number 2. They drew with us. We came here, ended number 1. We got a point. So we're very, very lucky. Whatever anybody says, I'm very proud of the boys.
Well done then, Coach.
Thank you very much.
Coach Owen de Gama saying that he's very proud of his players' performance tonight. Ill discipline, though, a big factor. The Mamelodi Sundowns fans very unhappy with the referee as he walked down the tunnel. There were, of course, 8 yellow cards tonight and 1 straight red for Ricardo Nascimento. Let's hear from Coach Pitso Mosimane. Coach, you looked frustrated. Is that fair to sum up how you feel about this game?
Yeah, very much. Very much frustrated.
Why?
The way the game went on.
What in particular was frustrating? Was it about your players?
No, my players did whatever they have to do. I'm not encouraging Ricardo to get a red card. I'm the one who speaks against that. Even Gaston's yellow card, I think, was uncalled for. And that's where I want to talk about my players. The other side, I'm not there to talk about it. It was very tacky, two combats, and the management of the game could be better.
When Serena got that yellow card, I saw you were sitting on the bench and you looked very frustrated, which is why I used that word. Did you say anything in the halftime break about discipline?
No, I was not happy with Serena getting a yellow card there. I'm not saying he doesn't deserve it. Probably the referee is right, and if he's right, he must give it. But what about the guy going through to Dennis Onyango a minute before? So they get frustrated. They are human beings. But what can I do?
And I want to ask you about Nascimento's red card, in particular his reaction, and also how that affected the team then playing with the man less.
Yeah, what are you going to do? But we tried to win also when we played against 10 against 11. You must understand, as much as we can really try and put discipline on the team, because I told them at halftime, I said, we got too many yellows. Let's not get the yellow card. I told them. But what can you do? It's frustrating. I don't want to say anything else. You know what I can say. You know what I'm capable of saying. But save money for my children. And what can I say, guys?
Coach, let's talk about the game itself then. Just the final question. You told me before you expect a tough game. You expect them to be tough to break down. And that's what you got.
Yeah, but there's a difference between tough and robust. You know? So you should manage that. Because it's all yellow cards, you know, it's robust. There's a difference between tough and tactically disciplined and robust. We were tactically disciplined after 10 against 11. That's tactical discipline, you know, but
So fair to say then, disappointed?
Yeah, a little bit of street football, you know what I'm trying to say? You know, without gloves and less box.
Thank you so much, coach. Good luck in the cup.
It's okay. He will improve.